Hey everyone, Eric with UptonBass here. We did a video a few weeks ago. Initially, it was just meant to be a response to a question a customer had about, you know, how our basses would do in his climate versus a base that was made halfway around the world in China. So we did a quick little video on it and got a lot of views and a lot of likes and a lot of comments. Thank you very much. So, you know, we put it up. I guess it was Gary and I had the intention that it would start a discussion and that we could go back and forth with y'all in the comments, and you did. And then a lot of good points were brought up. So Gary and I have been looking at back and forth, like, you know, we should do a bunch of follow-up videos going over, you know, not one big long video, but just lots of little snippets to go over some of these finer points. So, you know, one of the points had to do with the containers that they came in with. You know, I used to work for a distributor. I saw these, you know, bases, base bags, you know, cello cases, you name it, anything that came in a container. Inevitably, there was some punkiness going on from either water or just heat and things like that. And then, you know, I think it was like 2 or 3 weeks ago, a customer came on the showroom floor, professional musician, tours all over the country with musicals. And his touring group actually had to go overseas, and to save money on shipping, because they had to do not only the instruments, they had to do the entire set, costumes, PA equipment, everything that takes put on a musical somewhere. When the container got to their first destination, they could tell right away that the container had been breached, there had been water damage, and everyone from the cast and crew, they were all watching this container getting packed. Almost all the costumes, some of the actual set materials got damaged. I think they said the costumes were almost a total loss. And the musicians were freaking out, just waiting to see the condition of their instruments. And they were lucky, their instruments were in a portion of the container that hadn't gotten water damaged. But this musician, never seeing the video that I did a couple weeks ago, had just said, you know, said he was telling me the story, and I'm like, yeah, I know. But if right off the bat, he's like, I will never ship anything in a container ever again. I would never put anything, you know, to ship by sea that I actually cared about. He's like, you know, now when my touring group goes overseas, I pay the money and I air freight it. I bring it with me. And we get things all the time from European vendors. You know, we buy wood from Germany. And when wood comes in, first off, you know, the Germans, they pack it on pallets that, like, I save their pallets. I think their pallets are great. They're the best pallets I've ever seen. You know, they'll stack it high with all our wood. It's wrapped. The amount of effort they put into shipping things here is great. But even with that, some things can happen to the wood. And then there's also more of the point to the video of shipping things halfway around the world. It's wood, it's living, it's breathing, it's moving. It needs to stabilize. So when we get a shipment of wood from Germany, or if I get, you know, fingerboards from India, or, you know, whatever I'm importing in to finish off our bases wood-wise, I can't use it right away. You know, we have to first off inspect it, sort it, stack it. You have to stack it properly, store it, and then it has to go through a period of time where it's just sitting, waiting for us to use it, because it needs to be, you know, acclimatized. It has to get used to the humidity and the cycling of where we are before we can even use it. And of course, we ship bases all over the country, sometimes all over the world. You know, a handful of them go outside of the United States every year. So we're aware of the fact that, yeah, you do have to ship, and we try to do things a little different. Anyone who's ever got a quote from us has probably seen that our shipping quote is a little bit higher than the other guys, and it's probably got a lot to do with how we're doing it. We're doing express truck freight. We can hit most spots in the United States within 2 or 3 days. Extreme cases, if I'm going to like the Pacific Northwest, it might take us 4 days. We only ship on certain days. We watch weather patterns. I've stalled people's bases for a week or 2 weeks before because we didn't like the weather that the truck was potentially going to hit along the way. You know, I'd rather make a customer mad having them wait for 2 or 3 days rather than having something get baked or frozen or stalled out in a truck somewhere in the Rockies. So we pay a lot of attention to how we ship, when we ship. We're doing it a little bit different, again, than everyone else. And that's hopefully why you're buying a base from us. Everything from getting the wood in to building the base, putting it together, setting it up, and right to the last step, putting it in your hands, we're doing it different than everyone else. We're doing it in a way that is sustainable, a way that makes sense to us, a way that's gonna ensure that our instruments last far, far, far longer than we do. So I wanna keep the discussion going. Gary and I gotta pick some more comments, do some more little follow-up videos, and I'll see you in the next video. All right, bye.